What's this pink thing on my desk, you're wondering?
Well, what is this?
Japanese cherry blossom. I don't know what it is, but when I saw it, I couldn't wait to show you guys, and I'm gonna taste it for you live. I've been waiting to try that. Well, it does taste like cherry. So I guess it is cherry blossom flavor. It's a little bit weird. I think I preferred the peach cola from the other day. Hello everyone and welcome to another episode. This week is a little bit different. I had a devlog plan for this week, but since Godot 3.1 officially released this week and I had been waiting for it for a couple of reasons, I thought I'd show you how the porting of my project went and what are the features I was most excited to check out in the new version of Godot. Now, in this video, I'm not going to go through all the features. There was a huge list of things that were fixed, improved, tweaked, modified, and I'm just going to share with you the things that I had to go through when I upgraded, and also the features that I'm really looking forward to, or that I noticed right away when I upgraded. The first thing I noticed when I booted up my project in the new Godot is this little options at the top right, where you can switch between GLES 2 and GLES 3. That was something I was really excited about, because it means that some issues I had with rendering and shaders on my mobile phones and my mobile tablet were probably going to be fixed because of the support for GLES 2. You see, since I did my series on the special effects in Godot, I've always had issues where some of them were working, but some of them were not working on my Android platform. And recently I've been playing around with making some special effects in shaders for my wormhole. And the wormhole were showing fine on the PC, but on my phone and my tablet, I just got like nothing. And I updated, compiled with the latest version of Godot, and now everything seems to be fine. And so I'm really happy about this. It means I don't have to hold back on like doing some more effects for my game, or going into some more fancy graphics or something if I want to. One thing that took me a little bit of time to figure out and to fix is on PC, my touches were working fine, the camera controls, everything was looking fine. But when I built the first time on mobile, for some reason, I could move the camera, but it wouldn't take any of the game inputs, like moving the ship around or selecting a ship to attack or something like that. And at first, I couldn't figure out why. I had to look on the internet. I found the issue that referred to fixes on the touchscreen and touch inputs. And the way I figured out it happened is that you have this input mapping, and I'm really only using it for in one place, for touches on the player screen, which is one of the first thing I implemented. And the input mapping, the way it works is that you can specify a device and then a touch and then a name for that touch, and then you can test whether or not this touch by its name is pressed or not, which should allow you technically to map multiple bindings of different touches or different buttons or joystick input to the same event that you can receive later and process all the same way. This is really nice, but in 3.1 they changed it a little bit. They've always emulated the mouse buttons with the first touch you receive, but it used to be mapped to the device 0. When you create a new input touch in the mapping, by default it's gonna select the device 0. But now in Godot 3.1, the emulated touch from the touch screen that are mapped to the mouse button are on device -1 to distinguish them from actual real mouse button. It wasn't registering anymore on my phone with the default settings I had. So I had to go back in my input and change it to all device instead of just the device 0, which is the default one when you create a new touch. And I mean, it was a simple fix, but it took me a little bit of time to figure out how that works and why my touches suddenly stopped working. And if it wasn't from the issue ticket I found, I probably would have been still looking. Really, it's the only thing that kind of broke when I updated. Also, if you look around the editor, you can see that there's been quite a lot of changes, small improvements, tweaks to the look and feel of the general UI. For example, all the scene view is now much different, at least by default. I don't know if you can get it back to how it was before, but by default now it's a whole panel on the side. And on the right side, when you look at the inspector for all your node and stuff like that, the way it's done, I think, feels much more clean. You used to have to click and then select, like, if you wanted to link a node in one of your script, you had to click on the thing, and then you had to select a bunch of different options, file, node, erase, or change, or load, or something like that. But now it's much more streamlined. You click on it, the window pops up right away, and then you have little buttons on the side if you want to reset it or clean it or something like that. I kind of like it. The look and feel of the node inspector also has changed a little bit, but I guess I don't know if these are minor change or big changes in the back end, but visually it's not such a big change. Even though the fixes on the shaders for Androids were probably the most important reason I had to upgrade to 3.1 for my game, personally, as a programmer, the thing I was most excited about is a little something they call typed variables in GDScript. Right now they say it's not going to improve performance, but they did make a lot of improvement to the IDE, which will help on auto-completion and error detection if you use type variables. And without getting into a fight with people who really swear by typeless scripting language, I, for myself, really love typed variables. I said before, I come from more like a C++ background, and I'm used to having types, and I think it helps on both the readability and trying to avoid making mistakes, like passing the wrong type of a variable and then realizing way down the line that you're using the wrong thing. So personally, I think it's a great feature, and I'm definitely going to start using it. I'm not going to go back and port like my billions of variables I have right now in my code, but I think I'm going to start using it from now on. And the last feature, I haven't had time to check it, but I know it's one of the big features that came out with 3.1, is the addition of the animation tree and the whole new UI to manage your animations and be able to do blending between different animations using weights and stuff like that, which I know from experience that is going to be a very, very good tool for people wanting to do more complex animation, especially in 3Ds with walk cycle, jumping, and blending between all these kind of different things. It's gonna be great, and I'm really looking forward to trying it. I think I'm probably going to use it for some of the animations I have in mind for my weapons and stuff like that. It should help me chain the animation from like the shooting effect to the missile effect to the impact effect to the explosion effect and stuff like that, which I should be able to now do everything in one animation tree and just play this animation tree to the end. I think that's going to be really great, and I'm looking forward to checking it out, but I haven't had time to check it out. And so that's it for me, guys. I don't know if I missed any important features. Let me know in the comment section below. These are the things that I'm really excited about the 3.1, and I have to say I'm really impressed for a minor release. It's such a huge feature list, it's amazing. I can't wait to see what they're going to do with 3.2 or 4. Kudos to the dev team of the Godot engine, and see you guys in my next episode. Bye!